how to find the cube root of a binomial quadratic surd, also known as third order surd, or simply a cubic surd.
This video is an introduction to cubic quadratic surds in mathematics. To learn basic surds, I have left a link in the description to help you learn basic fundamental algebraic surds from the scratch for beginners. Solution to questions will come after this introduction. This video will show you the end of your result from the beginning and the basic conditions of cubic surds representation.
Before we look at the basic conditions of a cubic surd, let's recall considering a quadratic surd of the form of a plus or minus the square root of b. If we have a plus 2 multiplied by the square root of b, and we are to find the square root, the answer will be in the form of the square root of x plus the square root of y. Here is a plus, here must be a plus. A good example is 5 plus 2 multiplied by the square root of 6, all square root. Likewise, if we have a minus 2 multiplied by the square root of b, all square root. Our answer will be represented in the form of the square root of x minus the square root of y. Here is a minus, here must also be a minus. An example is 7 minus 2 multiplied by the square root of 12, all square root. Whenever you are given a quadratic surd of this form, your answer must be in this form. And whenever you are given a quadratic surd question of this form, your answer must be represented like this. This is whenever you're dealing with square roots of a binomial quadratic surd. But for the cube root of a binomial quadratic surd, the conditions are different. Also, consider a quadratic surd in the form of a plus or minus the square root of b. But instead of a square root, we're going to be taking the cube root. That is, for a plus the square root of b, and here all cube roots. Our answer will be represented in the form of x plus the square root of y. For example, if we are given this quadratic surd to find the cubic root, here the first term, which is a, has no square root. Our answer will be in the form of x plus the square root of y. Here x has no square root on it. Also, if we have a minus the square root of b, to find the cube root of this expression, our answer will be in the form of x minus the square root of y. Because here is a minus, here must be a minus. This is usually the first step before you start solving the question. For instance, if we have 72 minus 32 root 5, and we are to find the cube root of this quadratic surd, the first step is to equate this given expression to this answer. This is our step number one, which you are going to see shortly. But observe a variation. If we have the square root of a plus the square root of b, and we are to find the cube root of this quadratic surd, in such a case, because we have the first term having a square root and the second term is also having a square root, we are going to treat the answer like the square root of a binomial quadratic surd. And you are going to see the reason in an example. Here, our answer will be in the form of the square root of x plus the square root of y. For example, if we have 24 multiplied by root 3 plus 16 multiplied by root 7, and we are to find the cubic root of this quadratic surd, the first step is we are going to represent our answer in this form even before we start solving. In addition, if I have the square root of a minus the square root of b, and I will take the cube root of this quadratic surd, my answer will be in the form of the square root of x minus the square root of y. For this, an example is taking the cube root of 18 multiplied by the square root of 3 minus 14 multiplied by the square root of 5. The aim of this section is to enable you understand the differences in the representation of binomial quadratic surd when it is a cube root and when it is a square root. The first step to begin solving the problem is very important. If you don't understand the first step, then you won't be able to get to the final result. Before we solve some questions, it is important to mention here that if we have a plus the square root of b, all cube roots, and our answer will be represented in the form of x plus the square root of y. This can be rewritten as a plus the square root of b all to the power of 1 over 3 is x plus the square root of y. Next, a plus the square root of b, here we have x plus the square root of y. Next, if you remove this cube root, on the other side is going to be to the power of 3. That means we are expanding this bracket 3 times. Then you expand by distribution. This is always the second step when solving the cube root of a binomial quadratic surd. Now that you have understood the basic concepts in the square root and cube root of binomial quadratic surd, next, in the next session, we are going to take some questions and you will learn step-by-step method of getting to the final answer in any of the conditions. I hope this was helpful.